Brothers and sisters, as we continue our catechesis on the early Christian writers of the East and the West, we now turn to the brothers and Cyril and Methodius. They were born in Thessalonica in the early 9th century. Cyril, whose baptismal name was Constantine, was educated at the Byzantine court, ordained a priest, and became an acclaimed teacher of sacred and profane sciences. When his brother Michael became a monk, taking the name of Methodius, Cyril also decided to embrace the monastic life. Having retrieved the relics of Pope Clement I during a mission in Crimea, the brother successfully preached Christianity to the people of Moravia. Inventing an alphabet for the Slavonic language, they together with their disciples translated the liturgy, the Bible, and texts of the Fathers, shaping the culture of the Slav peoples and living an outstanding example of enculturation. Pope Adrian II received them in Rome and encouraged their missionary work. When Cyril died in Rome in 1869, Methodius continued the mission in spite of persecution. After his death in 885, some of his disciples, providentially released from slavery, spread the gospel in Bulgaria and in the land of the Rus. In recognition of the brothers' vast influence, they were named co-patrons of Europe by Pope John Paul II. May we imitate their strong faith and their Christian wisdom as we bear witness to the gospel in our daily lives. I offer a warm welcome to the participants in the 2009 Church Music Festival. I greet the pilgrims from the parishes of Sacred Heart, Dondozidon, Ilapayan, and Turan from the Archdiocese of Kota Kinabalu, Malaysia, accompanied by Archbishop John Lee, and also the pilgrims from St. Francis Parish, Singapore. I'm also pleased to greet the many student groups and all the English-speaking pilgrims and visitors. I extend my greetings to the various religious leaders present today who have gathered in Rome for an international conference of interreligious dialogue. I commend this initiative, organized by the Italian Bishops' Conference in collaboration with the Italian Minister of Foreign Affairs. I am confident that it will do much to draw the attention of world political leaders to the importance of religions within the social fabric of every society and to the grave duty to ensure that their deliberations and policies support and uphold the common good. Upon all those taking part, I invoke an abundance of the Almighty's blessings. Thank you.